This program is rated 13, recommended for family viewing.
It is another beautiful morning down here in Kampala, and a very good morning to you who's just joining us on yet another beautiful 2 hours of nothing but infotainment. That is happening today. My name is Derek Ainadash, and of course, talking about 2 hours, we're going to be giving you some news coming in all the way across different parts of this country. We are talking about news coming in from the eastern part country, as far as you know, their traditional cultural rights are concerned. That is Mbalo. We'll be getting into that. Are you ready, or you are not yet ready? Have you left that place because you're scared of being circumcised? We'll be letting you know on how that story is definitely developing. And away from that, we'll also be getting into some starting news that are making headlines. Now, apparently, some non-governmental organizations could be losing out on, you know, some of their employees as far as, you know, giving them jobs is concerned, because some of the funds have been cut. We'll be letting you know on some of the affected NGOs and why this is happening. Later on, we'll be having a conversation on Kachai that involves internet rights. Now, did you know that it is your human right to actually access the internet? Yes, I'm definitely sure that some of you did not know that. We'll be having that conversation later on, and we'll be having a legal officer in studio to give us more details regarding that particular one. Later on, we'll be getting into our love letter. Apparently, someone is going through a situation whereby every time she dates someone, they tend to go for cheyo and they never come back. Could that be bad luck? That is a conversation we'll be having later on top of the hour. And of course, sports this morning will be coming through at exactly 10:30. For now, let's get the show on the road, because it's about that time. You need to buckle up. This is Urban Today. I have Tina Fierce as well as Willis joining me right here from the command center. Good morning to you guys.
Good morning. Good morning.
How you doing?
We are.
It is a Tuesday morning, and it's one of those times where I feel like, yo, it's an interesting morning to be alive. I don't know about you, but I just feel it's a good thing.
I have a problem. I think he's going through some ish. Because he got in here and he started preaching to us.
Single people.
I am.
No, it's not about single. Let me tell you, Willis. It's
Willis,
about that time you need to acknowledge the fact.
There is no person who trusts the Lord, prays every day, goes to church every Sunday like a single person.
Jesus!
Mom!
He says it again!
But it's a good thing to be single.
Single
though.
People, they are the ones who sit on the first two rows in church. Single people always have their statuses with Bible verses.
Thank
on WhatsApp.
For the Lord saith.
Believe in God. Your time will come. What
happened
to you?
For he sets according to his time, not mine.
John chapter 3 verse 16.
Okay.
Single people, they were just quoting the Bible. John
3:16.
For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son.
Moving forward, what am I with?
But it's not a good thing, by the way, whether you're single or not. It's not a good thing. It's not a bad thing for you to actually know your Lord. So, don't you care if everybody's single? We know we are very single, but it's okay. It's understandable.
You're single?
Yes.
Are you
single? I'm single. Are you asking me?
I'm asking you. Are you single?
Yes.
You might be single, but someone believes they're in a relationship.
That is the most dangerous thing. You'd rather be single than being in a relationship alone.
Someone is in a relationship alone with you.
The Lord is going to guide you. Just call on to him. He's your provider, I'm telling you.
So
you
are single?
Believe in Willis. Huh?
Yes. You are single?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
What do you mean by am I single?
You are alone in a relationship.
No, it is the other individual.
You are not in a relationship.
What do you mean by am I single?
Are you in a relationship?
What is a relationship?
A relationship with someone.
Yes, I'm in a relationship with God.
God is not a... You see single people? Where about you? Are you married? No, I'm married to the Holy Spirit.
Didn't we see it? Did you see what the Holy Spirit is capable of?
Where?
Ask Mary.
Yeah, you know when you did those things, Omanyi, how things mutate in time.
Ngambo Bible. But anyway, Willis, we understand you come from the East, and when we talk about the East, we cannot go without looking at what they call Embalu. Embalu yatabusi abantu bali mbasa lebintu sibichegera. Abalala bali mukudukayo budusi. What's going on?
Embalu is a cultural a cultural tradition, a belief from from the Baba Itabacha.
Abagisu.
Wamasaba.
Wamasaba.
Abagisu mwa abaviteka womu about 21st century.
But nainga originally.
Abamasaba. Yeah. So they believe, you know, that in order for you to be a man, they have to circumcise you. And they don't do it by you going to hospital or going in a clinic or where. They have to do it traditionally with ceremonies and whatnot.
I have a dumb question to ask, because I think it's like dumb Tuesday in my world today. I'm slow, I'm a blonde. So what happens if the village members didn't see you partake in the Embalu session over the years? It means the village knows you're not circumcised, right?
Yes.
But then you beat them to eat and you go to a hospital.
It's very simple.
They have to
do the ceremony.
No, but usually what
happens... But you can't do the ceremony without the cutting of the thingy.
No, you can.
No, you can.
You can.
Hey,
you
think a ceremony is just cutting.
Because me, this is what I had from a friend. Yeah. He told me that, you know, once that happens, it means you're no longer man enough. Yeah. Apparently, in their society, they believe once you cannot, you know, take in that whole... you know,
the pain. Fact
that the pain, eh? That means you're not man enough. And when it gets to, you know, village decision making,
marrying
their women, you can't say nothing. You're
so
a boy.
Wait, according to them, it doesn't matter because if you get anesthesia, it means you are not a man.
Yeah.
You're supposed to feel their pain directly.
Live and direct.
And they don't give you those things of Simanya pain.
No, someone
and they don't use razor blades. They use knives.
It's a knife. But they told me, I have a friend who attended one of those ceremonies from the beginning, mpaka to the climax when they, and he said, walaya babantu tebaliboka. By the time that man stands there to get cut, he is begging for it.
Yeah, the thing is...
And then she told me, there is a part where they first go, is it like, kalinga kasawe?
Africans is that what you can't explain, you say it's witchcraft or it's demons. And
no, trust me.
The thing is this, that if you subject a human being to a lot of stress, too much stress, they can get to enough stress to stop feeling a lot of pain.
Yeah.
So that is
your
why
body numbs.
Scientifically, you're dancing, and you see the dance is not Musimanya this or over this.
Macarena.
No. It is you dance with your thingy,
your waist.
So when you're dancing with your waist, left, right, this whole body part becomes
tired.
Yeah, you get tired and you stop feeling a lot of pain.
And
that's why
numb.
He said that you get to that point and you don't feel the pain. So you're like, Bana, just do this thing. Never did a chibawo, take a man them.
That knife is so sharp, it's one take. Like,
so what happens if the guy mistakenly just, you know, digs in? In between
the guy who does that thing, well known. He has done it for villages and so. But here's the fun bit about that tradition, though. There is a girl that you have to sleep with. Yeah, the first girl you sleep with after getting cut. It's one girl, and that girl never gets married. It's like, I swear, ask a Mugisu.
Baba Itachi? Abagamba Baba Itachi?
Abamasa.
Tujafuna Mamasa abo mutu mbuze.
Dennis Duke.
Uyo Mugisu. Ate ya tolokayo. In the meantime, six people who were part of a group that was dancing to Kadodi, a culture ritual dance in the Mugisu circumcision ceremony, were at the weekend knocked dead after a speeding taxi rammed into them. Now, Nagalama Division Police Commander Miss Grace Nyangoma said the accident occurred at Gavu on the Kayunga Mukono Highway at about 8 p.m. We have five She said five others who were seriously injured and sustained broken limbs were rushed to various hospitals. This is, of course, something that is coming in as far as celebrating this dance is concerned. Also getting into some starter news coming in right about now. Now, apparently, Global Wire Industries director has been charged over 2.2 billion of fraud. Now, Rajiv Kumar, the director of Global Wire Industries Uganda Limited, has been charged with 53 accounts relating to 2.2 billion Ugandan shillings fraud at the anti-corruption court in Kampala. Prosecution alleges that Rajiv, 56, between April 2017 and April 2019, at Diamond Trust Bank Limited, forged documents signed by Kumar Rajendra, the co-director, and stole 2.2 billion Ugandan shillings from the company. Senior Superintendent of Police Bernard Sisi Kirie preferred and referred to the accused charges of embezzlement, forgery, uttering of false document, and the Directorate of Public Prosecution consented to them on December 19th, 2019. Rajiv, a resident of Bugolobi Flats, Nakawa Division, Kampala, is battling the charges under Section 19, 342, 347, and 351 of the Anti-Corruption and Penal Code Act, respectively. On conviction, the offense of embezzlement attracts a maximum sentence of 14 years imprisonment, while forgery and uttering of a false document leads to 3 years time jail. That's the gentleman right there.
Billion.
Mujani warie, no.
Billion.
Never kukona ka 2.2 billion. In an economy like ours, then you have to know you have really done bad.
Neya kakona 2017.
Neya kakona 2017. Mugezi.
Epo. Fool's day.
Well, let's move away from that and get into more starter news that are making headlines. Now, I was talking about hundreds of people who are about to lose their jobs as far as different NGOs are concerned after donors have cut funding. Now, hundreds of civil society organizations and non-government organizations are struggling to operate after Democratic Governance Facility suspended funding in some cases and cut budgets in others. Organizations involved in governance and human rights are the hardest hit. Now, according to the NGO Forum website statistics, CSOs and NGOs are responsible for a combined 500,000 jobs in the country ahead of the government that employs slightly over 300,000. Now, the development comes after a backdrop in the forensic audit last year that resulted in the support of four CSOs in the country being terminated. The audit was ordered by donors following an outcry of corruption amongst CSOs and NGOs in the country. Later, in a statement in the Norwegian embassy, one of the seven financiers to DGF related their disciplinary action as one that is being taken against DGF staff after investigations linked them to misconduct. It's very unfortunate that something we have been trying to fight to the extent of our very own president getting involved in the anti-corruption work is the reason why we're having these funds being cut that is going to be leading to a lot of people being unemployed. Corruption starting to, you know, be
civil,
the biggest crisis.
Civil rights, civil CSOs, civil society.
Society organizations.
No,
yes.
Civil society organizations come out to fight corruption.
True.
And dictatorship, and they are pushing for democracy and transparency.
And all those
but
things.
When they call for these summits, and they invite all sorts of people to attend, you invite a journalist who is paid by their organization to cover the story, to come and cover the story. When they get there, the journalists get fed properly. They also be given pamphlets of the information and also be given money. I don't know if that's a form of corruption.
But
I think it is. Mm-hmm. So if CSOs are doing, some CSOs are doing this, then I think, I mean, if the guy who's fighting corruption is corrupt himself, then
how are we going to do this?
Then there's a problem. And I think, you know, I think it's good for them to cut back some funding so that these guys put themselves in check. And we know... And we know where the money is.
We are trying to fight unemployment. And, you know, after this fund has been cut, you're looking at thousands of people losing their jobs.
True.
Why is that going to leave us as a country?
Here's what I'm going to say. I'm going to side with him. I think the only way corruption is going to die in this here country is if we are deprived of funds, is if we only have what we have to us as a country.
What we need.
What we need. Make do with it. Because every time you hear monies are getting taken in different spots, getting taken by different hoarders, it's usually donor money. Because that's the money that nobody actually ever bothers with. Like, before you know it, they're buying pens of Buumbiata. You get what I'm saying? So cut down the funding. It's good. I love when things like this happen. They are bad, but good too. Because it teaches us a few things. Let them keep cutting aid. Let them cut it.
It's a CSO guy in the motor kajavuga.
Baby.
I see a NGO. Nenga want to waga manti ala vidida. Mind most of these NGOs hide behind.
It's basically
that.
Like
we are helping,
like a church and
we are
its
helping
people.
Poor people. So you're like, okay, the head of the CSO is driving a Tundra. But the guy is helping, has been in the same state even before he registered in the organization.
It's a catch-22 situation, and it's very unfortunate that this is happening because of corruption. We do hope that we are able to deal away with this vice at the end of the day. That is the biggest prayer coming in from different nationals. Now, moving on to more news that are making headlines. Now, apparently, FDC is embarking on party reconstruction. The process of reconstructing Forum for Democratic Change, commonly known as FDC party structures in villages and districts, is ongoing, and so far it has been well done in Luwera district, says John Chikonyongo, the FDC deputy spokesperson. Addressing a press conference on Monday at the FDC headquarters in Najanankumbi, Chikonyongo informed journalists that the party has embarked on reconstructing its offices in villages and districts countrywide. Chikonyongo informed journalists that they wrote to police informing them about the process they are carrying out. He said they are, however, surprised that during the process of reconstructing, a police constable identified as Sekalema in Mubende district had gone ahead to disrupt the process. We appeal to the Inspector General of Police to inform police officers regarding the reconstructing process the party is carrying out so as to avoid any inconveniences from police or police officers, Chikonyongo added. He further informed journalists that they are to expect the reconstructing process to be complete by the end of this month.
Hey, get it.
They are losing. They're not going to take this election anywhere. Hey. I don't think.
Did anyone see them taking it anywhere?
Well, they could have. But the FDC members of parliament that are in parliament will still, in my prediction, still hold their seats. But they are not going to add any new member of parliament. And most definitely not going to take the presidential seat. Because you can't be reconstructing a party less than a year to elections.
What do you make of, you know, the ongoing fights within the opposition? We have seen, you know, a couple of disagreements as far as, you know, the opposition is concerned. Do you think that this could be, you know, played in the favor of the ruling party as we speak now?
Whether we have an opposition or not, that's an argument for another day. But I think that the disorganization in the opposition into the favor of the incumbent for me, because for him, he sits down and just looks at them. Imagine if you just like to follow what happened in the US, Donald Trump is always telling you, I'm very excited that the Democrats are fighting, you know, and it's Ma Pelosi.
Yeah,
and he's failing at his impeachment thing and sort of. So this disorganization, Akina, I remember, I think yesterday, Dr. Kizza Besigye was arrested. You understand? Then you say these guys are saying police is disrupting them. Then you'll hear DP saying, no, you cannot reconstruct a party when for us DP, the founders of democracy in Uganda, have not.
Then UPC will jump in.
UPC.
You but people we are power, the founding guys,
you
fathers.
You took our colors. Then people power will jump in and say, no, you see, for us, we represent
it's our people.
Other parties are fake.
So the incumbent, they're just
so
the guy's
like, okay,
with
when you're
popcorn.
Done. Yeah, like when you're done, eh? Let's meet in 2021
in January.
Let me
tell you, this is how it works. The best way to use your enemy is to make your enemy have in-house fighting. Because while they're concentrating on the fights in-house, where or taking up naughty, Besigye gone, Bobby Wine not going to be a problem. UPC, are they even on that ballot? But that's it brings another question I wanted to ask you guys. So did Bobby Wine finally register as people power
It's a movement.
It's just a movement.
It's not
a political party.
Because if he was going to consult, it means
it's Firebase in politics.
But what?
Have you ever? I don't know if Firebase is registered as a company.
I think it is.
I don't think so.
You can check on it.
Or your guy already said it.
Bobby Wine.
Would you get a firebase into your career about Vanch?
Yes.
Firebase, baby, could say, I'm coming in
as far as our starting news is concerned. Now, what we're going to do at this point in time, we want to go in for a very short break. But when we do get back, we have an interesting special version of Urban Today. Just a small segment that we would like to share with you. Have you bought the latest copy of the Bride and Groom magazine? Now, you stand a chance of walking away with an interesting gift. I'll be letting you know on what that gift is, and we'll be having a live draw carried on this show right about now, immediately after this break.